Tribal Gathering is an annually organized festival on the Caribbean coast of Panama. Different tribes from around the world come together to share their individual challenges and experiences. This goes hand in hand with festive events for the visitors traveling to the festival. Each year, the festival cleans its beaches from the continuous plastic waste arriving from land streams and the ocean. This year, the organization wanted to do it different. The reoccurring problem of plastic waste would be shown to the visitors to create more awareness of the issue. In order to create this awareness, it is also important to show positive solutions. For this reason, I arrived here. Next to the Caribbean coastline, we set up our workstation. In our setup, we have a shredder and injector machine. Two times in a day, we gave workshops on the topic of plastic recycling with in-depth information about the different plastic types. In combination with the workshops, we also coordinated the general beach cleanups alongside the festival.
The UV degradation.
For this workshop, we only recycle plastic lids made from polypropylene. Before we start the recycling process, we make sure to carefully clean the lids. By separating the lids into a variation of colors, we can create a big variation of new recycled products.
Come on,
Glenn. Yeah, acá tengo dos. Venga, venga. Mas, mas, mas.
After injection, we take the mold of our injector and demount it. We clean the remaining irregularities of the process with a knife. To make sure we label the plastic type on our new product, we heat up our stamp with the number 5 and press it on our plate. The end result is a fully new, recycled product made out of plastic lids found on the beach.
There's often like post-consumer plastics, old flip-flops, a lot of flip-flops around. It's like old things to fix your hair. This is like the origin of how a plastic PET bottle is being used in the industry, and then of the shape of the mold, it actually becomes something like this shape.
So the majority of the things you find
is water bottles,
foam.
In the industry, plastic bottles are often recycled, but then you see in places like here, which are really remote, that there's no infrastructure or facility to bring these materials to.
So at this moment, there's still a lot of waste material, which is actually really useful for making new products, lying around everywhere in the nature.
My name is Enrique Murillo Perez, but you can call me Rico for the rest of the video. I am an electrical and mechanical engineer here from Panama. And today I'm going to talk a little bit about garbage. Look, whatever we have here is something that's being found in the beaches of Panama, but all garbage has a story. It's simple things. This is core. Obviously, this is one of the most reusable things here. We have different ones. The marine core, this definitely clearly come from the beaches here in Panama that we use for some fishermen. This is good for lines for the boats. It's a consequence for working, but really throwing away, they don't look into throw away any of these things. Okay, this is interesting. This is something very difficult to get rid in Central America. The reason why is because it's used for the sheep meals. People sell a lot of sheep meals on the street, but they use this a lot. So it's the only affordable way to, you know, they have your meal ready, they give it to you, poof, they give you one of this. This become immediately will become garbage. Doesn't matter where you are, this thing will happen. It's the only affordable way to prepare this meal. The meals just travel like probably a meal made of homemade will travel more than 10 kilometers to reach their final destination, which is any construction area. It's important to notice, everything that is here is not metal, because metal is difficult with became garbage. It's really, really rare. Metal is some of the most recyclable products on the planet. That is interesting to see in this one here. Every plastic container that can contain a liquid still have a value made of any material. Other cuts that you may find is this one. It's an, let's say, an improvised funnel. It's a good one. This can hold, this can resist like oil and other products. Some people here cannot afford to go every day to the store to buy just one of these, so they sell it massively. These tubes are particularly interesting. A black tube actually doesn't represent electricity. This one was for water projects. You come out there, they were a little bit more flexible, and there's a problem with this thing. After a while in the sun, it gets really rigid, depending on the quality, consistency. But you know they were from a project because you see cuts like this. Very good cuts. These babies over here, of course, the shoes. The shoes. This is the part that I call bad engineering. And we go for garbage that is just bad engineering. You know, these shoes, low quality shoes, probably the glue that's being used here or screw something, they just fell. So how you fix it? I can see here they're mostly sandals. That's a classic one. We all had a problem with the sandal. This is a classic problem with sandals. This is a three problem with sandals. Two-layer sandal, it lost the glue here. Done, heat does that. One engineer problem that has been mentioned to me like today, and I wanted to address, they said they found a lot of this. There is a simple explanation. Look, if you buy a fan in Central America in general, near to the coast, sunny place, these fans, you need to clean the blades. But you need to clean the blades probably like once every month. Then you need to detach this thing. Clean the blades, attach the thing, take the thing, attach the thing, clean the thing. So what people do is just take it away because it's bad engineering. The clamps who hold this part are terrible. So they make of plastic, cheap metal. So metal against this plastic really doesn't work. But so people just buy the fan, take out this part, throw it away because they know it's gonna be just a hassle. And at one point they will break. So what do you think this is? They show it these days here. But guys, this is a styrofoam that is already have some creatures growing around it. You know? You saw. And that brings us to a very important topic about this thing. Oh, it's very sad. You know? The creatures are growing around this piece of garbage, but they do not understand that.
So, from all the waste plastics we don't use, we cannot recycle because the workshop is too small for this. We bring it to the back where the festival is. Here we have a big stack of all the plastic beach waste from the beach. As you can see, we have a lot. What do you think about this place?
Esto debe ser más lejos para allá, para que no se vea aquí en el pueblo.
Sí.
Sí.
Aparece un poco feo, ¿no?
Sí.
Oh man, it smells so bad in here. And there's so much smoke everywhere as well. It's of course not very healthy to walk around. There's a cow lying here. Of course there's places which are even bigger than this landfill. You start close to where the beach is and then people actually burn it on the spot. Next step would be that you really have like your garbage being picked up and then brought to the landfill here, and here they just burn it on a daily basis. So the question is like, what do you do if you come in a place where everything is made from plastic? There's no infrastructure to actually dispose all this waste, but there are so many objects here which are all from plastic because it's such an easy and cheap material and it keeps everything clean and it's so light and easy to bring this everywhere. And everything is plastified. They still sell also all the plastic forks, plastic spoons. So if you, for example, want to buy bleach, there's a lot of need for hygiene.
these kind of products only arrive in these plastic bottles. They don't come in glass bottles because if they break, the bleach is everywhere in the transport. There's really a rough road, so there's a lot of opportunities that these products get damaged. So it's a difficult problem. So what you see also often is these huge bottles, which are really sustainable. There's like, of course, made from plastic, but it's really hard plastic. It's this type is a plastic, is PET, but sometimes it also comes in polycarbonate. These are really strong, durable bottles, and they actually only replace the lids. So these lids we also found a lot on the beach. But these bottles are a really good like example of how you can make a sustainable, clean water system. So people cannot really drink anything from the regular taps, so they need to have new, refreshed, like cleaned water, also with the UV light. And then you get these kind of bottles, and they just deliver it all the time. So as soon as you...
Me llamo Micaela. Estoy aquí en el festival para representar a mi país Guatemala y mi comunidad Sutujil. Cuando compramos carne, llevamos un recipiente para echar la carne para no traer plástico en la casa. Era nuestra cultura antes, pero lastimosamente la contaminación ya viene con más por la tecnología, por las industrias, por las empresas muy grandes, son las que nos trae, cada vez nos acerca cosas para contaminar nuestro medio ambiente. Que nosotros los mayores debemos de evitar de usar el plástico. ¿Por qué? Para que el niño va creciendo con la cultura, con las costumbres que la mamá o la familia le enseña de no usar plástico.
As you can see, solving the problem of plastic waste is a big challenge. The introduction of new bottom-up recycling methods is one way to offer a solution, together with using alternatives for plastic objects, like they do in the festival. Avoiding to buy plastic at all is by far the most effective way to solve the issue. Sometimes this means you have to stick to the more ordinary choices,